The opioid epidemic resulted in a nationwide crisis, but over the last few years, a lot of research and focus has helped educate the public and curb the crisis. Addison Kerr explored just how the crisis impacted key players from the legendary 1996 team. Addison?
Thanks, Tanner. The opioid crisis was handled a lot differently in 1996 than it is now. We'll hear from just one of the players that experienced this epidemic firsthand.
Injuries are all but inevitable in football, and prescription drugs allowed players to play through the pain that came along with those injuries. But in 1996, players and team doctors didn't know just how intensely addictive opioids could become. Doctors thought they were just doing the players a favor. Several players on the 1996 team became addicted to opioids, and one, Brad Martin, a linebacker, eventually passed from complications of years of drug abuse that began at BYU. Derik Stevenson, a teammate of Martin's, separated his shoulders during a game against Alabama. He was given a manila envelope with pills inside to tide him over for the plane ride home. That was the beginning of his addiction.
Yeah, I just wasn't really prepared to deal with, you know, how the drugs were going to make me feel, how much I would learn to like them throughout the course of the entire season.
Derik hid his addiction for fear of getting kicked out of school. Opioids wreaked havoc on his life. It took years before he was able to get clean.
You know, I just decided that I needed to start being more honest and vocal and not be so ashamed.
Derik now works as an advocate for recovery and speaks to current college athletes about his story and the harsh reality of addiction. In September, he attended the BYU versus ASU game, where the 96 team was honored in front of 65,000 fans. As the team stood at the 50-yard line while lights shone down, someone from the crowd went from person to person, writing something on each teammate's hand in black Sharpie. On everyone's hand was the number 10, Brad Martin's number, a teammate lost to opioid abuse, a reminder to never let it happen again.
The whole team just talked about how we were being honored for having such a great team and such a great season in 1996, 25 years ago. All of us, you know, something was missing, and we knew that it was that Brad wasn't there.
Although the opioid epidemic still exists, it is much more difficult for athletes to obtain addictive prescriptions. Coaches and doctors have made it a point to educate their players on the addictive qualities of these drugs and to help and support those that might be struggling. Our knowledge on the subject has come a long way, but as with anything, there is still a long way to go.